Welcome to Miles of Music. I'm back again with the international violinist Christian Howes. Hey, Chris. Nice to see you.
Thanks for having me.
I have to tell you, I've been a fan for years, as I've said earlier, and I've seen you many times. Going on your website, it says you play all styles. You play bluegrass, jazz, rock, whatever you can, classical, of course, which I think is pretty much a given for violin players, correct? Classical.
Not always,
no?
Not always, but often, yeah.
Sure. Obviously, as a classically trained violinist, you had to learn to read music.
Yeah.
But to play at this level of improvisation, you have to have a great ear as well.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So you work on the ear also, or it just came naturally?
Well, I was trained in the Suzuki method, and the thinking behind this method is that, you know, for children between the ages roughly of 2 to 6 years old, their ability to learn language is at its most optimal level. And that's how children learn to speak. They listen to parents and the people around them and they learn to speak that way. Mm-hmm. So that's why the Suzuki method encourages learning by ear at that age, because then you learn the musical language, you know.
Right, right.
And so by the time I was 8 or 9, my ears had really developed.
And that's how you teach today?
I teach at Berklee College of Music. I teach college-age kids. I teach older kids, too. I focus on teaching improvisation, mm-hmm. because there's lots of great classical teachers out there, but I teach about jazz. And I have an annual camp called the Creative Strings Workshop in Columbus, Ohio. And string players from all over the world, they come, all ages, to study improvisation on string instruments, violin, cello, viola, and it's a real fun time. We perform concerts all week long, all throughout Columbus, Ohio, and you can learn about the Creative Strings Workshop at my website, christianhowes.com.
I know you have a lot of CDs out, and it would not surprise me if you just, you know, went on and on and on with a list. But this is your first most recent, I should say, on Resonance Records.
That's right, and it's probably the first record that has such a high production value. Because I've always made my own records over the last 11 years, and finally I've signed up with a great record label that I feel really comfortable and happy to be with, and it's called Resonance Records. Mm-hmm. George Klabin is the producer, of the founder of the label, and he really kind of took me under his wing and enabled me to, or I should say he produced this record for me, brought in some great players, Roger Kellaway. And so I'm really proud of the record. It's called Heartfelt.
Right, right. I've heard so much about George because of Joe D'Onofrio and Kathy Rocco.
Sure. Kathy's also on Resonance.
Is a Resonance recording artist. And I just have to give him so much credit to put people like yourself on here that are just out of control, you and Kathy. It's as good as it gets, and it really is, it really is.
Well, Resonance, they really do care about the music. They're not as bottom line oriented, you know.
Right.
they're really, and especially George, he's really, you know, he's really into the music, and so they're making a statement this year by releasing a lot of great records, and they intend to stick around.
And there's a club associated with this, I believe?
Resonance Records is really aligned with philanthropic work supporting the arts.
And they're one of the few record companies that really have tremendous talent. They just don't do it to sell records. They do it to promote.
Absolutely.
Great talent.
That's
and
right.
I respect that. I really do. It's been a real honor to have you, Chris. Your website again?
Oh, it's Christian Howes, H-O-W-E-S, okay. ChristianHowes.com.
Chris, it's been my honor.
It's my pleasure.
And we'll come back and do a second show, okay?
Appreciate
and I'm looking forward to hearing you.